When the next election comes and people are allowed to vote freely, not the kind of pressures that they had earlier.
Hello, viewers. Welcome to Kashmir Live Interviews. Amid the rumors about the restoration of the statehood and the delimitation commission, today we are joined by the National Conference's Provincial President Kashmir, Nasir Aslam Wani. Mr. Wani, welcome to Kashmir Live.
Thank you so much.
My first question is National Conference being approached by the central government?
Personally, if you ask me, I am not privy to any such thing, but it is high time that a political process has to start in the valley. People of the state, erstwhile state, are suffering due to many accounts. After 2019, everything has changed. The politics of the state has changed. The constitution of the state has changed. Even we have bifurcated into two UTs. The governance of the state has altogether changed. A few bureaucrats and an LG cannot run the entire UT for such a long time. You can understand their compulsion, which was primarily after 2019. But now it is high time. They should reach out to the people, because it is now becoming suffocating for
them. So there is something behind these reports.
I said personally, if you ask me, I am not privy to any such.
I'm asking you as the provincial.
They should. I think government, I mean, it's high time that you can't just shut your doors for everything. And in politics, it's better that you resolve certain issues.
So, is it from your end that now you are talking about participating in the delimitation commission? Basically, you're backtracked. You basically said that the JNK Reorganization Act is not valid.
Why are you presuming things? हमने अभी तक जितनी भी आपस में गुफ्तगू की है, हमारी इनर सर्कल्स में जो बातचीत हुई है, ऐसा कोई नहीं है कि बस हमने फैसला कर लिया है कि हम वहाँ जाएंगे नहीं जाएंगे. कुछ सवालात हैं जो जम्मू कश्मीर नेशनल कॉन्फ्रेंस ने उस कमीशन से भी पूछे हैं, गवर्नमेंट ऑफ इंडिया से भी पूछे गए हैं, कोई जवाब आया नहीं. जहाँ तक रियलाइजेशन का ताल्लुक है, वो सब जुडिस है, सुप्रीम कोर्ट में उसका केस चल रहा है. वी हैव चैलेंज दैट. लेकिन ये आप प्रज्यूम कैसे कर सकते हैं कि हम अगला स्टेप क्या करने वाले हैं? ये तो कोई अभी बात तय हुई नहीं, ना हमने ऐसा कोई फैसला आपको सुनाया.
ये जो पीएजीडी की मीटिंग हुई, ऑल ऑफ अस सर पीएजीडी रिसरप्टेड, सो इज इट बिकॉज़ देयर दिस इज ऑल अ फोटो ऑप टू कवर द डिलिमिटेशन का प्रोसेस जो आप उसमें सोच रहे हैं जाने के?
सी, आई कांट हेल्प व्हाट यू आर प्रज्यूमिंग. लास्ट फ्यू मंथ्स, इफ यू लुक एट इट, देयर वाज नथिंग हैपनिंग पॉलिटिकली और इवन सोशली. Because of the pandemic, people were hardly meeting each other.
The pandemic started in May.
I'm telling you, before that.
PAGD met in December.
So after
what
that.
Happened throughout the winter?
It's not that. You have to meet for certain issues. You can't just meet and discuss the weather of this valley or the weather of the state. You should have some issues to discuss. As rightly after that meeting, Dr. Saab has said that it is better that whatever we take it, whatever is the future course of action, it is by consensus. It is better that if you have a consensus, because that action or that decision has a far-reaching consequences, not only for our political party, but this Jammu Kashmir UT as a whole. Let me complete. Because NC is committed to do anything and everything for restoration what we have lost on August 2019. And this perception that some section in the media or that either there is a sellout or they have decided to go back to the delimitation commission, even if we go, for example, let us presume, even if we go, it will always be for the people's good.
My question is that if the PAGD met, they reiterated basically the same thing which they did when all of you were released from detention. So what has changed? What have they done? What has the PAGD?
No, what has changed on ground? We are still on the same position. We are still saying that whatever was constitutionally ours, as a peace-loving mainstream party, which was never taken, we can't just go on streets and start fighting. This is a constitutional battle, which we say that it's a constitutional right, and we will fight constitutionally and within the ambit of the mainstream politics to get it restored. And it is the same. Nothing. If the position on the ground hasn't changed, how will the stand of the party change?
So this statehood has basically been promised by Home Minister Amit Shah. He has basically promised that it will be given back. It's the agenda of few political parties here also, which are now propped up. So would you fight an election if the statehood is not restored?
It is again a hypothetical. Is there an election? Because have you heard anything about? No, that is his individual. That is individual. If you are asking me a question on behalf of the party, I am saying it is totally hypothetical. There is nothing on the offing. There is no election happening. Either you are privy to something that you know the election is happening, you are asking me. As far as we are concerned, as a political party, we see nothing on the horizon.
There are reports that the statehood might be restored. Even if the statehood is restored, would the National Conference fight the election?
See, we will cross I will again tell you the same thing, Yavar sir. We will cross the bridge when we reach it. When they announce the elections, we will see whatever is in the benefit of the people of the Jammu and Kashmir. We will do that step.
PAGD, a party left the PAGD. So there were differences on the ground when you fought the BBC elections. Do you believe that the PAGD is going to survive if they don't meet for 6-7 months continuously?
Either.
Because Tarak Gandhi sir told me that not meeting is detrimental to the whole process. So how do you see those statements?
Let me correct certain confusions that you have. Either you are asking me questions as office bearer of Jammu Kashmir National Conference. I am not here as an office bearer of PAGD. My party is a constituent in PAGD. These questions you are bringing to a wrong desk. All this either goes to the convener of the PAGD or their spokesperson or the chairman. It is not my mandate to answer questions on behalf of the PAGD. You can ask me questions on behalf of the NC because being a provincial president of NC, I can
I'll ask you a question about your counterpart in Jammu, Devinder Singh Rana. He has been basically propagating a Jammu declaration. So has it been mandated by the party? Because there is a Gupta declaration.
To be very honest with you, it has not been mandated by the party. There has no discussion ever been done on this. But whatever my colleague in Jammu has said, it is better for him to explain on what basis he is saying it and what are the parameters that include.
Is it like that National Conference has Gupta declaration for Kashmir and Jammu declaration for Jammu?
Nothing. I told you very honestly. Nobody would have been so honest with you. This has never been discussed in our forums. Neither am I privy to any such discussion about any declaration which has come up in Jammu.
Has he raised this issue?
No, never. Never in the party forum.
So has he been asked that why is he making up this Jammu declaration?
That the General Secretary, I can only tell you about Kashmir promise. That you will have to ask my General Secretary.
So about this political outreach, there has been political outreach in Kashmir, even in Jammu. But what about the Punjab, Chenab Valley and also the Jammu Sindh Heartland? We don't see the national conferences, big leaders going and reaching out to people.
It has been an outreach for every region. When we have a working committee meeting, there is a representative from every region. When the leadership asks for a ground report and a ground assessment, there is every regional leader who is there in the meeting and in the decision making body. Not only just reporting to the party, but they are in the decision making. Whatever decision the party takes, that is for the Jammu Kashmir as a whole, including Ladakh. We as a party have not left Ladakh out of our organization setup even today. We have a proper organization setup in every region of this of Jammu and Kashmir.
So how do you respond to this question of National Conference teaming up in Ladakh with the BJP?
Good you asked this. When the council came up, there were certain independent councillors who had joined hands with us and the council was formed. For their better judgment, when PDP was in power, these councillors were with PDP. They joined them officially and they were part of PDP. After this bifurcation, they decided to switch over to BJP. So we have not changed our stance. They have been switching party. Now the local unit has decided to head that council. So they are still heading. These people who were associated with BJP for some time have also decided to disassociate from BJP and be an independent again. So it is for the local thing, which that arrangement is still there, I will not deny it, but it is, we have never tied up with BJP or any other party. They were independent councillors.
Are they still independent or are they with the BJP?
I will have to check that, whether they have already done that, but the local unit has assured us that we will either have our own council there or we will not have a council at all.
So in these DDC elections, you basically yourself contest from Srinagar. You have lost the DDC post in Srinagar. So it's the capital city. So what happened?
You lose elections, you win. You can't always win. We lost assembly elections in 2014. That is not the end of the
world. That is not
the end of the world. Sometimes you win, people are you have better candidates who win, and sometimes circumstances are such. And basically, you know what all happened during DDC elections. It was a new experience for every political party.
But there is a political party, a key party, they have managed to win in Shopian, they have managed to win in Srinagar. So why hasn't National Conference been able to win? Because these were your best and at least Srinagar you used to win.
Some things are better not answered.
So does that mean that something else happened?
Everything happened. Dand, Ved. Everything was used for getting those elections. So let us leave it that. That's an old story. Let us see when the next election comes and people are allowed to vote freely, not the kind of pressures that they had earlier.
Because when you elect something like this, but you have one in the other district, why didn't it happen there? Why just in these two specific districts?
There are many reasons for it. Some of the reasons our Vice President Umar Saab explained in that press conference also. We had an audio recording of certain things which he even released to the press that time.
So my question is on the People's Conference, which was an ally in the PAGD. They basically won two districts, the most in two districts, in Kupwara and in Baramulla. So did they win on their own or
No, unfortunately they didn't win on their own. We gave them full support. Actually, even in certain cases, their candidate couldn't even campaign. Our party cadre, our office bearers were the ones who made them actually file them the nomination papers also, and made them go around, helped them go around for campaigning also. And we transferred our full support to them to win those DDC elections.
So, basically what you are saying is that it was the National
Conference's
support which aided them to.
Yes, in many places, definitely.
DDC members in various districts have been saying that they are not allowed to move and have been confined.
Unfortunately, yes. They are in a miserable condition. They have been housed in these hotels and they are not being allowed to go out. Kabhi security ki wajah se, kabhi dusri wajah se. Bahut mushkilat hai unme. काफ़ी लोग बीमार भी हो गए, मतलब हमारे कुछ डिस्ट्रिक्ट प्रेजिडेंट हैं, एक वो भी डीडीसी मेंबर है, वो फंसे हुए हैं. हमारे बड़गाम ज़िले के तो बहुत लोगों को तो बिल्कुल ही हिलने नहीं दिया जा रहा है. इसी तरह बाकी जगहों के बहुत ज़्यादा परेशानी है डीडीसी इनके लिए. वट एवर द रीजन आई डोंट नो, आई एम नॉट प्राइमरली दे से येस, बट आई डोंट नो वट इज. And if they are not allowed to go, then what was the point of having these elections? If the conduct of election was done on this premise that the security scenario is totally peaceful, and then why cage them now? Why don't you let them go out? Why don't you let them meet the same people who have voted them in?
So what they told me is that whenever they want to step out and go to their respective constituencies, they are being told that there is a security threat.
That's what I'm telling you.
Is it happening to the other leaders of your party also?
Many, many issues. That's a different...
Are you also being curtailed to go somewhere?
Most of our programs are not happening because they don't let us go out of the
institution. Kabhi ek security ka bahana, kabhi dusra security ka. Aapko ek batao, we had an incident, unfortunate incident in Sopor, where the councillor was killed, put a minute trap, hamare पुली की माँ और बहन दोनों काउंसलर से वहाँ पे जिन बाल बाल बच गए, उनका पीएसओ मर गया उसमें. सो आई वेंट टू सोपोर अलॉन्ग विद माई मेम्बर ऑफ पार्लियामेंट एंड अदर कुलीग्स. इवन आफ्टर रीचिंग सोपोर वी वर नॉट अलाउड टू गो टू देयर होम्स.
सो रूमर्स आर बीइंग राइट दिस डे अबाउट बाइफर्केशन हैपनिंग. इट वाज बेसिकली a DLG who came in yesterday and said that nothing of this sort is going to happen. But don't you think there's a pattern from 2019 onwards that the government isn't doing enough to quell these rumors? Mm. Have they been doing enough to quell? Because on the ground, people are really disturbed. They are rationing.
If you look at the rumors in 2019, they all came true. So there was nothing for the government to dispel them because they must have been privy to all that. Today, I am glad the LG has come out. He has said nothing is happening and he has been very categorical. I hope it is that way and we leave it at that.
The ceasefire has been agreed between India and Pakistan on the border.
That's the only best thing that has happened in these couple of years.
So, do you think it is the beginning of something in Kashmir?
It should be. That is a good thing. But the very fact that the ceasefire is in place is a huge relief. Because the more friendly these two countries are, it is beneficial for us, and God forbid when they are firing at each other, we are suffering. And we are suffering on the both sides of the LOC. When you shell the other area, people of the same erstwhile state get hit, and when they hit it on us, we lose precious lives. So the peace on these the border and the LOC is directly related to us. We benefit and also suffer because of this peace. We are really glad that the ceasefire has come in, and we hope that it is a beginning of a far-reaching dialogue between the two countries so that we have a permanent solution for this region. We have suffered for so many years. And I hope and pray that our future generations somehow see a better day in life.
It's on a report basically published in an international news organization that fake domicile certificates have been issued. So how do you react to this?
If something like this should be probed thoroughly, and I think this is high time that we don't get into these kinds of scams so early in the day. If this starts now, I don't know what will be the fallout of such an action.